Hello, I'm Joey Wiedle, Bixby Fire Chief, City of Bixby in Oklahoma. Here today at Pierce to show you our new truck. We went with the mid-mount, and we went through Roger Brown with Conrad Fire. He helped us spec it out and get the best truck we could get for our fire department. So what you see here is a little different than some of the other departments. We went ahead and added the extended bumper so we get the hose lay put in front here. We do like for that for our smaller department and crews that we can pull those off for a jump rig on a dumpster fire or a car fire. So we'll utilize that. We have the rotator light in it, and then on the corner there we'll have our own service bell that we took off our last engine that we will incorporate and put on this truck. You'll notice also down the sides we've got cameras for side view cameras that we'll be able to, when turn signals come on, we'll be able to see and transition traffic safely to make sure no side vehicles with a longer truck. We're in a metropolitan area that's fairly urban, so lots of traffic, so it'll be a safety feature for us. Also, you got the shoreline for charging, keep the truck up and running. This will be a truck for us that we'll try to man as we're growing. We're looking to hire some more personnel and hopefully we'll man it 24/7. But not every shift will it be manned, so we'll need it to be grounded and charged at all times. We do have here on the outside, on both sides, we have cabinets that'll open up, and they're also going to open up from inside. We run medical calls and fire. About 80% of our calls are all medical, so we'll be able to put our medical gear here. It's easier to feel and check the rig in the mornings when we're running calls. And then access from inside the truck and be prepared when we get on scene. So the front interior, what you see here is we tried to upgrade the seats, tried to upgrade the interior. We did a better package on the defrost, the heater, climate control. Some of the trucks we have now, we have a hard time in Oklahoma with the conditions being hot and cold within a day of a 30 degree change. So it's nice to be able to set that temperature and make sure the truck is comfortable for our crews. Obviously, with the TAC 4 suspension as well, it should be a smoother ride for our guys. Obviously, back injuries are a big problem with us, so if we can make it comfortable and safe, that's our job that we're trying to do for our guys. So looking in the back, we just got the two jump seats in the back. We'll run three guys per truck. So we didn't see the need of having four in the back. We wanted more medical space and space for tools on the back wall. So we've got seating for four in this truck. Another feature we added on this on both sides of the truck was cabinets to house the fire extinguishers, water cans. So that way they'll be at waist height. They'll pull them out easy and store them. Truck does have just the 300 gallons on it, but that's really not an issue for us. Well, like I said, where we're at and where we're going to utilize, we'll have everything there for hydrants. So we've got good water distribution. They're close by, so the 300 gallons is good for us. Mobility of the truck is going to be a bigger key for us being tight. We do also have on this truck, we went with the camera system. It's up top that can be accessible by an iPad down on ground so we can get eyes in the sky, see a fire scene. We could also use it in fire investigations to put that over and be able to see what the actual fire conditions were and what any fire mapping may come about on that. Another feature that we have is the cameras for the outriggers and letting us know that it's okay to go ahead and deploy the outriggers. For the truck, one of the great features on this particular truck is the integrated pads, so that, you know, obviously we're not having to place all of these pads in on this truck. They'll all deploy, self-leveling, and that's a good feature for a smaller department like us. And this cabinet, first time really we ever seen this was on this truck when we came. We always are having a place, hard time finding a place for tools. Those type of things that get thrown in a bag, lost, or a mess. So we really like having the built-in toolbox for this truck. And obviously with the tilt racks, that's nice to be able to see your tools, especially for people that have a challenge of heights like myself being shorter. We have the airbags, place to house all those. So that makes it convenient that everything's where it needs to be and has a home. So we're excited to get this home, get Conrad to help us get the thing rigged out with all the tools in place. Again, the same thing here. We got the tilt down rack. It's gonna allow us to access the tools easier. This will be mounted inside. It's for maps and books for inside our cab. And then we'll slide this rack out again for our heavier items, accessibility. You get really a lot of good storage out of a truck that is smaller for a 100-foot ladder, dual axle, tandem axle, but we are able to optimize a lot of storage with some of these features we've thrown in. Again, just another slide-out rack that we can pull out. And we've got the tool board here. We can mount some other tools and have everything in line. Optimize the storage again. One of the other things that's kind of unique, everybody kind of puts a touch on it, but we've got our school pride, community pride, that's Spartan Head. So our school is Bixby Spartans, and we worked with them to get something added to the truck to put a little touch on it. So here, obviously, we went to the American flag for some American pride. And we also have, like the storage, we do meet all of the NFPA and ISO requirements to be able for our storage. Again, smaller truck, but still able to meet that and get the maximum points is big for us. Pike poles, all the ladders have a place to be. And another convenient thing is they're not high, they're low. Easy to pull off, put back in, stow away. We got the task force tips up top, dual tips, tandems. Convenient too for that to be able to switch from solid to fog, operate those from the ground or up top is also another convenient. And then we have a 2.5 that we can utilize in the event, parking garage, some of our other buildings that maybe we don't have a standpipe system that we can utilize and hook into that and use the waterway as our standpipe system. Again, same thing on this side, tried to replicate everything we could. We worked with Roger on trying to get tilt out trays, try to get the pull out trays. Again, convenience, get it comfortable for the guys to pull stuff off, put it back on the truck without injuries as best possible, and optimize storage. You also see here we got our Fotokite. We did purchase a Fotokite with this. We're grateful to the city and council and city manager and city citizens of Bixby for allowing us to get such a truck. We're excited about the night spots, black. We like that. Won't show the dirt, grease as much, and then we're backlit with the red LEDs so you can see really good during the day and or night. So we're excited about that feature, and we're definitely excited about the photo kite. Going to the center of the compartment, we went with the swing out toolbar. Again, doubling your storage capacity, giving us place to mount tools on both sides. We'll make that convenient for everybody to get to and place for all the tools to be. Just another little storage compartment gives us a place to put some of our jaws and that type of stuff. We like the Hamaltro battery powered. Those work really good. We've got 4 or 5 sets of those now with this new set being added to it. So we're excited to have those tools on this truck as well. Again, just another little storage component that we can put some other tools in and mount some of our other accessories that we need here for this particular truck. We'll probably have some hydrant wrench, spanner wrenches, and some storage connections with the water mains being on this side, discharge and intakes. Camera on this side as well that will deploy. Essentially lets the driver, gives the driver awareness that it's okay, you're in a good spot. and that if you're in an alleyway, you've got cars that are in the way, it gives you the ability to see without getting out of the truck, am I going to be able to deploy these outriggers, and am I in a good location to do so? So again, on the, we went with task force manifolds for our intakes for the truck. So we're really excited about that task force done as well. And we think that they'll be convenient for us on this truck with the manual, the way that we like to fight fire and pump operations in Bixby. On this side of the truck, we added for another fire extinguisher pump can. That way it's low. We all know those are heavy, and it's easy to store here in convenient location. Looking at the back again, you've got an outside compartment that we can open up, access, and then also the roll-up doors. So we did the roll-up doors here. Easy to get to, no netting, and it rolls up and convenient. This will be the captain's side here. When we get this rig back to the house, we'll put in our software, we'll have our CAD system in here, we'll have mapping. We run that off of iPads and we utilize ERS. And right now we are looking to move into Streetwise and or Rover, and we'll get that done when we get back to Oklahoma. But we really like the truck. Again, comfortable seats, safety features are there. We just like the TAC 4. We had that when Pierce first came out with TAC 4 when we bought the trucks in 08 and 07. And so it was reliable then. We didn't have any issues, and that's why we came back to it. We liked the ride. So up top, you'll see we have in memory of Chief Abel. We also have his badge number, 901, up top. Chief passed away in 2018 of August, and he's actually the reason, one of the larger reasons why we went with a Pierce. He brought Pierce to Bixby. We had the pucks at that time. We went with TAC 4, and we went a different route. And now that we're back to being able to buy another truck, we decided to go with Pierce TAC 4. And so we really wanted to dedicate this to him and tell him thanks. Well, I just want to thank you guys for taking the time to watch the video. We're really excited about the new truck. We can't wait to get it home. We appreciate Pierce. We thank Roger Brown with Conrad Fire for helping us. And we'd more so like to thank the citizens of Bixby, City Council and leadership for allowing us to get this piece of equipment that is well needed and will do us a great job for years to come. So thank you all for your time.